Hello everyone, and welcome to Kyle Academy. My name is Professor McVeigh, and today I will be helping you better understand some of calculus's tricky subjects. So let's get started.
The first subject we're going to cover today is derivatives. So we're going to derive the function x plus 1 over x minus 2. But we need to remember to use the quotient rule, which is log x minus 2 times the derivative of the high, which is just 1, minus high x plus 1 times the derivative of the low, which is just 1, all divided by the low squared. All right, and then we're just going to go ahead and clean that up. So x minus 2 times 1 is just x minus 2. Minus x plus 1 times 1, which is just x, and minus 1, because you need to distribute the negative, all divided by x minus 2 squared. All right, and we're going to clean that up just a little more. So the x's cancel each other out, and then negative 2 minus 1 is just negative 3. And the bottom is x minus 2 squared. And there's your answer. So now we're going to use the first and second derivatives to find the maximum, local minimums, and where it's increasing, decreasing, concavity. So first we're going to go ahead and take the derivative of that. So that's equal to 3x squared minus 12. So then you're going to set that equal to 0. Mary minus 12 is equal to 0. Add over 12 is equal to 3x squared. X squared is equal to 4. And that gives you x is equal to plus or minus 2. So those are going to be your critical points. So you can go ahead and put them on a number line here. So negative 2 and 2. So this is where the graph's going to change from negative to positive, or decreasing to increasing. So anything smaller than negative 2, you're going to go ahead and plug that back into the first derivative. So you're going to get 3, 9, 27. That's going to be positive. And then 0 would be negative. And anything larger than that is going to be positive. So on these, on negative infinity to negative 2, it's going to be increasing. And negative 2 to 2, it's decreasing. And then from 2 to infinity, it increases again. Alright, and then we're going to go ahead and draw all this. So then we're going to go ahead and do the second derivative. And so f double prime of x is going to equal, put that, so that's 6x, and that's it. So x is equal to 0 is going to be your point of inflection on this one. Inflection. Alright, and then we'll do the number line test again. So let's plug in negative 1. So anything to the left is going to be negative, anything greater than positive is going to be positive. So it is concave down from negative infinity to 0, and concave up from 0 to infinity. And we can figure all of that out just by finding using the first and derivative. Don't even need to graph it. Alright, now I'm going to demonstrate how to do simple integration. Our bounds on this problem are going to be from 0 to 4, and our function is going to be x plus 9, all of that cubed. So to integrate, all you do is you add 1 to the exponent, then you divide by the new exponent that you used. So it's going to be x plus 9 to the 4th, instead of 3, and then it's divided by 4. All right, and then we're going to evaluate it on the bounds from 0 to 4. And then we are going to use this equation. So it's going to be f of 4 minus f of 0. So you plug in 4, you can use your calculator, and it's going to equal 7,140.25. And then f of 0 is going to equal 1,640.25. So simple subtraction, and the answer is going to be 5,500. Now we're going to make it just a little bit harder. We're going to integrate using substitution. So you need to look for a pattern. So in this one, like the x squared, the derivative of x squared is equal to 2x, and that matches up here. So our u on this problem is going to be the inside here. It's going to be x squared. And our du, just the derivative, is going to equal 2x. But since there's no 2x here, you're going to have to times this side by 1.5 to make them equal. So 1.5 integral of cosine, substitute u in there. I forgot what dx is. And then du. Alrighty, and then we're going to go ahead and integrate that. So 1/2 times cosine integrate, the integration cosine is equal to sine u. And then we're going to plug back in our u. So 1/2 sine x squared is going to be your answer. Alright, now we're going to go over slope fields. So if you recall back to the first derivative test, when you take the derivative and you can plug in an x coordinate, it will tell you if the function is either increasing or decreasing. So slope fields are similar to that. It gives you the derivative, and then if you plug in an x coordinate, it'll give you the slope at that point. So we're going to go ahead and demonstrate here. We're going to go ahead and plug in 1 into this, and you'll get 2. So slope's 2 at all of those points. Alright, and then we're going to go ahead and plug in a 2, and then it would be 4, and then it would be 12. Alright, and then going to the other side here, this would be negative 2 for all of these, and then this would be negative 4, so it gets a little steeper. Alright, and then negative 12, so it gets very steep. Alrighty, and then if you plug in 0, you just get 0, so these would all be flat. And then we'll go ahead and draw what the graph might look like, just following down your slope. So, and then it gets, flattens out, and then it gets steep. And that's it.
I hope some of these mini lessons today helped you better understand calculus. Thanks for watching.